Hello everyone, I'm Antsa and welcome to Let's Play Indianapolis 500 by Sega. And this is arcade version.
Please select the course.
Let's start with the Highland Raceway.
Highland Raceway. Please select the transmission.
So I have never played this game. And I don't remember this being that popular in arcades.
Ready, go.
Is there a... yeah. Oh, this is nice. Yeah, first person view for such an old game. Seventy laps, be a part. I guess there's no damage. I wonder why they didn't do any real tracks apart from Indianapolis. For example, Long Beach or Road America or Latin Sega. For 1995, these graphics are truly magnificent. You wouldn't see this level of graphics for many, many years. If I didn't know, I would say this is from 1998. Maybe even early PlayStation 2 game. Or Dreamcast. This part reminds me of Latina Sega. Not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but it has that corkscrew turn. that was a dragon. Oh, what are you doing? This is not destruction derby. I can't remember what was that dragon game for arcade. I think it was released somewhere near the year 2000. Also, I have fond memories of the arcade game that has had a like a flying bicycle, and you have to pop about or gather balloons. It was an interesting concept. And the cabinet was a real bicycle, so you had to like exercise. But I guess that kind of game mechanics are pretty difficult to emulate. Laps to go. Once again, the music is quite repetitive. Usually it is game sessions last for a couple of laps, but I forgot that I changed the settings so that this is the maximum length for the game. In real arcade halls, they want to maximize the number of players that spend coins for the machine show. So probably the default lap count is 3, or for the Indy 500 maybe 6 or 7. And I suppose this game was also released for Sega Saturn. But as usual, those conversions, even though they were technically quite an achievement, usually they didn't add any new tracks, so to pay $60 for game that it's only 3 tracks. So it's not very worth the money spent. Proper driving game must have at least 10 different circuits. And yes, you can reverse them and do mirror tracks, but that's cheating. There should always be at least 10 different circuits. I remember Toka Race Driver 2 had so many tracks. It was a wonderful game. Sadly, I think nowadays it costs so much just to do one track and have a photorealistic graphics that the developers usually create only a couple of tracks. The exception is Codemasters. They have at least 20 tracks for Formula 1 games, obviously. But I think Race Driver Grid had too few tracks. They had a few version of a single track, but that's not the same thing. You don't want to just drive a different route in the same location. You want to have a different scenery as well. Okay, I think I will just barely run out of time. Weird bird, it's just staying at the same place. Finally I made that turn right. Four laps. It's not enough. In reality, this track wouldn't be possible. There are no catch fences or tire walls or anything. It's obviously too dangerous. Nowadays, maybe in the 60s, this would have been possible to make. No tracks beside monoclass tunnels. Okay.
Sorry. Time is up.
Well, 30 minutes of racing. That was nice. Anyway. Okay. Let's do other tracks next time. See you then.